Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create powerful blue glass images and text floating in deep space from scratch. This is an update of a tutorial I did quite a while ago on an earlier version of Photoshop. Before we begin, I want to mention that I'll be going a bit faster for more advanced users. I provided this image that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is located in my video's description or project files below. The name of the font that I used is Terminator Real NFI. I provided that link as well. Feel free to replace it with your own design or your own text. My document size is 1920 by 1080 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. If you're using your own design, make sure your document is the same size and resolution as this one to ensure that your result will look similar to mine. If your design is on a white background, as in this example, we need to separate it from its background. To do this, open your Magic Wand tool. Make the tolerance 5, check anti-alias, and uncheck contiguous. Click inside any of the black areas to make a selection of your entire design. If we didn't check contiguous, the only area that would have been selected would have been the character you clicked. The other black areas would not have had selections around them. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut it out and place it onto its own layer. Click the background to make it active. We'll fill it temporarily with white, but first, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since white is your background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Make your top layer active. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively and even replace our design with another without having to redo most of the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hide the copy and double-click an empty area of the layer below it to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay. Click the color box to open the color picker. In the hexadecimal field, type in 1732FF. Then click OK. Click Inner Shadow. Click the color box and this time pick black. The blend mode is multiply and its opacity is 40%. Make sure global light is unchecked and make the angle 120 degrees. The distance is 20 pixels. The choke is 30%. And the size is 14 pixels. Then click OK. Make the top layer visible and active. Control-click or Command-click the thumbnail to make a selection of your design shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 12 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. Click the FX icon and click Color Overlay. Click the color box and this time type in 159FFF. Click Inner Shadow. Click the color box and type in 0F3CFF. Click OK. The blend mode is multiply. The opacity is 100% and the angle is 120 degrees. The distance is 0 pixels. The choke is 42 pixels. And the size is 13 pixels. We'll make the top two layers into one smart object by shift-clicking the bottom design to make it active as well, and clicking Convert to Smart Object. If you want to angle your design's perspective, go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. Go to a bottom corner and drag it out to an angle that looks good to you. Then, press Enter or Return. If you want to stretch the top of your design, open your Transform tool again by pressing Ctrl or Command T and dragging the top middle anchor point up. Then, press Enter or Return. Next, we'll place our design onto a field of stars. Make the background active. We'll fill it with black. And since our foreground color is black, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 100%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 0.3 pixels. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. For the input black level, I'll type in 213, and for the input white, I'll type in 232. However, feel free to adjust these amounts, which control the star's size, brightness, and amount. By the way, the reason we use an adjustment layer for levels is so we can go back and adjust the brightness, size, and the amount of stars at any time. Make our design active. We'll make two copies of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J twice. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Sketch folder and click Chrome. Make the detail 1 and the smoothness 0. Change the blend mode to Vivid Light. To make it look like glass, click the adjustment layer icon and click Curves. We need to restrict the adjustment layer to just the one layer below it, so we'll make the adjustment layer into a clipping mask. To do this, either click the clipping mask icon, or press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows, or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Drag the diagonal line into bell curves similar to mine, but feel free to adjust them if you like. Scroll to the bottom of the Layers panel and make the bottom design layer active. Go to Filter, Blur, and Radial Blur. Make the amount 100, the blur method Zoom, and the quality Best. Drag the blur center to a position that approximates the location of the bottom center of your design. If you need to, you can reposition the radial blur at any time. Next, we'll add a lens flare. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Fill it with black and change the blend mode to Screen. Go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. Make the brightness 140% and the lens type 50 to 300 mm zoom. Drag the lens flare to the upper left corner and click OK. Next, we'll add a blue cast to the lens flare. click the adjustment layer icon and click Hue Saturation. Check Colorize and make the hue 228 and the saturation 100. Let's reveal the original colors of the lens flare on the lower right. To do this, we'll brush in black over those areas of the adjustment layer's layer mask to reveal the lens flare below it. Open your brush tool. Make its size 1200 pixels, the hardness 0, and the opacity and flow 100%. Go to the bottom right corner and click a few times to reveal the original lens flare. Lastly, let's brighten those areas. Click the new layer icon to make a new layer and change its blend mode to overlay. Invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard. Now, white is your foreground color. Reduce the opacity to 50%. Then, click once over those areas of the lens flare to brighten them. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.